Oh, well, to do on Sunday, so fun. The milk carton boat race is back. And I mean, these vessels have to make a trip across the lake. And yes, some do actually make it, survive. We have Adam Baker, Aurora Rosarian Prime Minister, is here, and Megan Spruth, the Oregon Dairy Princess Ambassador. And Orlando,
I'm ready.
Checking out this
vessel. Put me in, Coach. I'm ready.
See if it's ready. Adam, let's start with you. How does this competition work, and where does it take place?
That's the Westmoreland Casting Pond down in southeast Portland. And the boats start on the east side of the pond. And there's different classes of races. There's singles, there's families, there's youth, there's adult, there's corporate, there's showboat classes for the, you know, kind of the best in show.
Are you showboating right
now? It's from one side to the other, you know, and if you get a little bit of wind, sometimes you start in lane one and you end up in lane four.
I can use a little wind right now, my man. I'm getting a little tired.
Well, the bear's not helping much.
Megan, you know, we I don't know if we can see down here, but those are milk cartons under a piece of plywood that are holding Orlando up. How do you know how many milk cartons you need?
So it's all based on a math problem. The cardboard ones hold about four pounds, mm-hmm. and then the gallon jugs hold, I forget how much,
8 pounds.
8 pounds. So it's all a big math problem. It's based on how many people you're gonna have on your boat and how much weight. So it's all a big math problem. So it's a lot of fun to build one.
Guys, I thought we were talking like little milk cartons that were going to race down into the water.
No.
Like, this can hold people.
Yeah.
You know, there is a guy that comes out every year and has a little remote controlled one. But no, these boats that we're talking about for the milk carton boat races are people riding them and powering them across the pond.
So not everyone can be a competitor in this like I am. No?
In your suit.
In my suit. But do you guys have any tips for watching the event?
So this year we're encouraging people to bring a picnic lunch out, to bring some sunscreen and some water and just, you know, enjoy the whole day. It'll be 2-3 hours worth of racing starting at 11 a.m. on Sunday down at Westmoreland Casting Pond, and come enjoy the different classes of races.
How many of them sink, Megan, do you know?
That's a great
question. Have you seen that happen over the years?
I have seen that happen. Not too many. But some kids kind of fall in on purpose sometimes, so, and it gets a little competitive, so sometimes they fall in, but the goal is to not fall in and make it across.
And tell me about the association being a dairy princess to this particular race, obviously milk cartons.
Yes, so as a Dairy Princess Ambassador, we travel around the state of Oregon promoting the dairy industry and talking to kids and adults about dairy cows, dairy farms, and dairy products. So this event is really exciting because we get to hand out chocolate milk this year and other promotional items, and as well as taking pictures with families.
It'll go well with that picnic lunch.
Yes.
And June is the June is Dairy Month, and milk is the official beverage of the state of Oregon.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, I was impressed with your skills there, Orlando.
You know,
I think you're ready for the competition.
I feel like I'm a natural for this.
Now, is there a prize, a grand prize, a cool trophy?
There is.
A carton of milk?
So there's ribbons for the different individual classes, and then there's in the kind of the best in show class, there's a big metal milk carton that your or milk can that your name would get engraved
on. Wow.
For all eternity. And it's not too late to build one, Orlando. It's
not
too late.
It's the Super Bowl of milk carton boat racing. Hey, thanks so much for coming by today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.